My goal in this video is to give you an intuitive description of the heat equation. Now, it's not going to be a derivation or a rigorous discussion, just an intuitive description. So the heat equation is UT equals gamma UXX. And this equation is often referred to as the diffusion equation because it describes a phenomenon of diffusion, and heat is just one good example of something which diffuses. Now, gamma is a constant greater than zero, and it's often referred to as the thermal diffusivity. And it will come from material properties of the model that we're dealing with, and it will control the rate at which the heat will diffuse. Let's start with an experiment. Let's say we have a metal rod, and we heat it up. So we put some candles underneath it, and we wait a little while. So you get some hot spots above the candles, and as you move away from the flame, it'll cool down a little bit. Now, let's take away those candles, and let's make a few assumptions about what we've got. First thing to do will be assume that the rod is small enough that the temperature is constant on cross sections. This means that if we take a little slice of the rod, everywhere on that slice, the temperature will be constant. Now, this allows us to talk about the temperature of the rod using only one spatial coordinate, and that is the left to right position on the rod. The other thing we'll assume is that the rod is insulated, and essentially you can think of wrapping some insulation around the outside of it so that you'll lose no heat from this surface, and you'll only see the heat move back and forth inside the rod. Let's use the variable U to represent the temperature in the rod at a horizontal position x and a time t. So another way to visualize this heat distribution that we've drawn here is simply as a graph of temperature versus position. So if you fix a point in time and you look at the temperature profile as we've artistically rendered here, you can see the hot spots are these humps, and it gets cool and then hot like this. So this is at some fixed point in time. Now the question is, what happens to the temperature as time passes? Now let's try to answer this question just using our intuition. So let's start at the top of one of these hot spots. So I go over here to the hottest spot. Now everywhere I look around me in the rod, it's cooler. So sitting at the top of this hot spot, I have no choice but to cool down. The temperature must go down. Same thing goes over here. Meanwhile, at this cool spot in between the two peaks, down here in this valley, everywhere I look around in the rod, it's warmer. So the temperature at this spot has no choice but to go up. It must get warmer. I can represent this with some arrows, so I'll draw some arrows in here. At the top of this hot spot, it's cooling down. Same thing over here, and in the middle, it's warming up. Now let's move a little ways away. Let's move over here, just to the right of this peak. What's happening here? Well, if I look to the left, it's warmer. And if I look to the right, it's cooler. But it's sort of more cool to the right than it is warm to the left, and so it seems like it's going to have to cool down. Meanwhile, if I look a little bit to the left of this cool spot, it's sort of more warm to the left than it is cool to the right, so it's going to have to warm up. And these two will meet in the middle somewhere. So I can kind of fill in the rest of this picture with some arrows using this same intuition. And it's going to be cooling down a little bit more slowly farther away from the peak. At some point, it will be not changing at this instant in time, and then it'll be warming up on the other side, etc. What does this picture mean? Well, you may notice that these arrows that I've drawn in here look very much like they represent the concavity of this temperature profile. Now, they might not be exactly the concavity, but they certainly have the same sign as the concavity. And the simplest assumption would be that they are a constant multiple of the concavity. They're proportional to it. So the conclusion is then that the change in temperature is proportional to the concavity of the temperature profile. And that is, in an equation, UT, which is the change in temperature, equals gamma UXX, being the concavity of the temperature profile. So there may remain a small question about the sign of gamma. And it's not too hard to figure out what the sine of gamma is. All we have to do is look at, say, when the curve is concave up, so UXX is greater than zero. So say we're in this bowl here, the curve is concave up, and the temperature must be growing, so UT must be positive. And that would tell us that gamma is greater than zero. Similarly, I could look at when the bowl is facing down, I'm concave down, and uxx would then be negative, and so ut would have to be also negative. Temperature would be going down. Another thing to notice here is that if gamma is very large, for instance, ut would then be much larger in proportion to uxx. And so saying that it's the thermal diffusivity is not such a bad name for it, because if it's very large, then the heat will diffuse very quickly. And if it's very small, it'll diffuse more slowly. Now, just because I like to look at things in as many ways as possible, let's take away this picture of the temperature profile that we drew here, and let's think about this in another way. Let's consider a point x in the rod, a little slice here, and some nearby slices, x minus h, x plus h. Now, you'd expect that the temperature at this slice at x would be going up if the average temperature near x was bigger than the temperature at x. And you'd expect it to go down if the average temperature near x is smaller than x. And that is represented by this quantity here. The average temperature near x is u of x plus h comma t plus u of x minus h comma t divided by 2. And so if the average temperature near x is larger than x, then this quantity will be positive. And if the average temperature near x is smaller than the temperature at x, then this quantity will be negative. So the temperature at x goes up or down according to the sign of this quantity. Now you'll notice this looks a little bit like a difference quotient. In fact, if I dress it up just a little bit, multiply by 2, divide by h squared, this becomes the difference quotient for the second derivative, uxx. So I encourage you to work that out on your own if it doesn't look familiar. So if I took the limit as h goes to 0, that would give me the second derivative with respect to x. So the sign of uxx is the same as the sign of this quantity. So that says that uxx will be indicative of the temperature change at x according to this argument that we've presented. So again, this is not a proof of the heat equation, but merely just an intuitive description, a plausibility argument that the heat equation would be a very simple way to describe the way in which heat diffuses inside a one-dimensional, more or less one-dimensional object like a thin rod. Now we'll find that we can do a derivation of the heat equation, and that will follow from a fundamental physical principle known as the conservation of energy, and we will do that shortly.